Hello YouTube. I've been sure if I should talk. Jesus. Usually I don't, you know, like to just not talk, and I think that's because I'm partly largely winging it with these paintings. I feel like I'm gonna talk, and it kind of just messes me up. Talk if I don't quite know what I'm doing. Relying on sheer talent and luck to make this work. But what I should do here is trying to get the whole big shape of these flowers before I get to individual ones, which are just to get it fitted in the whole. It's going to be this close-up of some daffodils. Group of batch of daffodils. And, I think I should get the whole shape of them first of all before I started getting too much individual ones too much. And I'm drawing a sign with the vine charcoal onto this 8x10 canvas, which I had is a toned canvas that I toned with a little raw sienna, acrylic raw sienna, just a thin coat of raw sienna acrylics on there. And although I'll be painting with oils once I start painting, I'm gonna get these all loosely drawn in, but accurately placed, I guess, is what I'm doing. These are daffodils that have like white petals, and the middle part is yellow. And I'm just gonna mask in the white petal part first, and I'm just using paste, kind of grayish color, but it's really purple, a pale purple. It's some white paint with ultramarine blue and some red magenta. And it's not too thick of paint. I thinned it down a little bit, some medium. I'm using use liquin. That's also, I thin the liquin down a bit with Gamsol. It's not pure liquin. More or less flat, but I think I want to vary it a little bit. Well, a little bit darker. I'm going to throw a little orange in. Keep it gray. Purple. A little darker there. A little lighter. Mostly going for a dark, well, a medium to darkish value to block in. And I'll build up the lights as we go along. Now we might as well block in the yellow centers, which are the daffodils. They have like little like trumpet like things. I don't know what there's a name for them. I guess they look like trumpets, kind of, not really, but. And I'm just using yellow and orange. And block it in with thin paint, as I said. Liquin with the thin down with Gamsol to Gamsol thin down liquin. And here. And I might as well block in now some stems. And I'm just using ultramarine blue, some yellow for the blocking. I think I'll put some white in, make a and a blue. Finally, the background is going to be just black. So I throw a little blue and red in to this black. Just that's how I like to do it. Give it a little variation, I guess. And that's the same magenta and the ultramarine blue that I lock the white part. Complement the yellow centers. So violet. So I guess that might work. I think I'll try restating the petals, kind of this almost the same color. It is the same color because I had already, but it's more blue and orange to make a gray color, and bit darker, maybe restating the petals, but also start getting some of the where the darks are established, I guess, if that makes sense. And this paint, maybe, keep talking, and some of the background mixing in is okay because it's a gray color anyway. Maybe mix a little bit darker, a little just more blue and orange. Thank you. So kind of restating your white petals, but this is in the lighter, it's some of the lighter parts, and I'm just using, this is now like more white, a lot of white, and probably a bit thicker paint, a little more impastoy, that I mixed into the that same grayish color of started out a purple color, that ultramarine blue and magenta, and also then some orange in that, or just, you know, because the orange and blue make nice gray color.
Mm-hmm.
about time I start restating trumpet centers. And just using some yellow orange color, just mixed with yellow and orange. And going from somewhat darker and just adjusting the shape of it, concentrating on the more darker parts and to some extent. Maybe go in a little bit lighter bits. Now I'm just adding a little more yellow. Add some white to that yellow-orange mixture and yellowy side. More yellow and white. Trying to suggest that crinkliness. It seems to have yellowishness on the petals. That's more reflecting the yellow trumpets, and also maybe I think the light is shining through them and making it yellowish looking, reflected the kind of yellows. I'll just get that on here a little bit, suggest it onto here. Wherever it goes. a deep shadow where it shows up in just a couple of these flowers. The center of that trumpet. And I just make this darker color with some of the black color with a lot more magenta with the black color and then some of the yellow color, yellow orange, and makes the dark shadow in there. And where it's not as dark, I can put a little more yellow or yellow orange in there. A little bit more orangey, somewhere else a bit yellowy. I guess that went a little darker than I wanted, just a little bit. Lighten it back up a little bit. I think I want to shape in this, cut in with the background a bit to shape these up. Blackish violet color mixed. I'm gonna go a little back and forth with the, I think a petal needs to be there, and then And just adding some light. I think the light's hitting the petals. Not. A little lighter, a little, you see some darks, some lights. Sometimes I think it needs, could go a little bluer in this part, I think. Nice color going on. Like a bluer gray. Violety gray. Maybe. More of a yellow shining through onto them. Petal making it yellowish on the white petal. I think this flower is probably the main flower. You want to sort of the focal point flower, I guess. Try and get that more, suggest more details than that, maybe, because it has more details to suggest or something. Maybe build up some contrast of the dark background against any light, possibly. Maybe it could go lighter here. Just pop that one out. And just try and get that trumpet part looking nice. Get about time to do some stems. Anyway. brighter green up in here. So I use some Thalo Green, yellow, and a permanent green. Or you could mix a little bluer in. If it's a little less bright. A little white into that permanent green, yellow. Yellow and Thalo. Pronounce it Thalo, did I say? Whatever it's called. Thalo. Thalo Green. But then it has this grayer part wrapping in here. And it's just, I don't know, maybe some of the gray from the petals. And if you want a little more magenta, a little more orange or something in there. I'm coming in here somewhere. Well, it's kind of dark. Just get that stated in with some dark. Isn't going to be exactly. I could add some white. Make it lighter. A little Thalo Green in the mix if I want. Not exactly copying exactly how the photo is, but just put some stems in. Looks like it's about all I can do with this painting. I want to keep it kind of some spontaneousness to it. It's not going to be super realistic. A little bit more. It's realistic, but not too tight. A little more loose and spontaneous going on there. I guess that's about it. Thank you so much for watching my video, and if you would hit the like button for me, and if you're interested in seeing more videos, you might want to subscribe.